Gentlewoman from California, Ms. Speier.
Ms. Speier, the gentlewoman from California is recognized.
Thank the Speaker. Thank you, Chairman Engel, Chairman McCall, and to Mr. Smith, and a deep sense of gratitude to Congressman Schiff for introducing H.R. 296, and to my sister, my Armenian sister, Congresswoman Eshoo, for helping us plot this strategy to get this bill to the floor. April 24th, 1915, is a day that lives in infamy in the hearts and minds of millions of Armenians worldwide. It's a day that I grew up understanding for my Armenian mother to be one of the darkest in history. It's the day that the Ottoman government embarked on a systematic slaughter of 1.5 million Armenians, two-thirds of the Armenian population. This genocide is recognized in countries around the world, including Canada, France, and Germany. It's recognized in 49 states in our union as the first genocide of the 20th century. Yet the House of Representatives hasn't recognized both the genocide occurred and that the Ottoman Empire perpetrated it. Elie Wiesel called it denying genocide, and in particular the Armenian genocide, a double killing, because it not only exterminates a group of people, it murders the memory of that crime. Congress must ensure that memory is not destroyed and those lives are honored. As a child, I listened to my mom speak of the atrocity with pain and fear. She is gone now, but her pain lives on in me to this very day. By righting this terrible wrong, one that has festered for far too long, we are alleviating that pain and sending a message that history can't be rewritten. We are stating in no uncertain terms that America will no longer abandon Armenians with feeble excuses made for a so-called ally. We are affirming that truth is truth. Thousands of documents totaling 37,000 pages in the National Archives supports the truth. Armenians were exterminated by Ottoman forces and Turkish sympathizers. In 1918, former President Theodore Roosevelt sent a letter saying, quote, "Because the Armenian massacre was the greatest crime of the war, failure to act against Turkey is to condone it and means that all talk of guaranteeing future peace is nonsense," unquote. Usually these words serve as a general warning, but today they apply to specific ongoing atrocities. We must not stand silent as Turkey attempts the ethnic cleansing of the Kurds in Syria. Even Russia's President Putin had said, quote, "The Armenian people went through one of the greatest tragedies in human history." Iran's former vice president stated the Ottoman Turkey government perpetrated genocide in 1950. If our rivals can talk about this, if they can take a stand, certainly we can. Armenian genocide, we must say it is here, it happened, it will never happen again. We must make that commitment. I yield back.
Gentlewoman's time is